is not Steph Curry, but he is Steph Curry at
his mentality. He will shoot the basketball over and over and over.
The guy's won 2 MVPs. He's a champion. Shattered every 3-point record the league has seen.
His favorite player is Steph Curry. Reminds me of Steph Curry.
He reminds me of Steph Curry.
Sick looking to win it here. Trae Young from the G and Georgia Tech.
I wanna go far, there's no stopping. I see them watching, I see them waiting. One day I swear I'ma be on the station. Mama, I gotta make moves.
Say what you want. You don't have to like the Warriors. You don't have to like Stephen Curry, Klay Thompson, the Big Five as it is right now. But Stephen Curry is one of the most unique players to ever play this game. When he first came into the league, no one quite understood this, so they just constantly bashed it. You heard players and, you know, former players and commentators saying jump shooting teams really don't win championships, and they were right because history proved that jump shooting teams, it doesn't usually win championships. But the Warriors, and mainly Stephen Curry being the, you know, the pioneer of it, they proved everyone wrong. Even though I kind of believe jump shooting, that was proven to work even before Stephen Curry, because in 2014, I watched the San Antonio Spurs team blow Miami out and LeBron James by so many points because they were just having incredible ball movement and they were shooting threes. They were shooting the lights out. I mean, almost like everyone that started averaged over 40% from deep. And as a team in the NBA Finals when the Spurs beat the Heat, they averaged a team total of 46% from deep. And that's pretty incredible. They were almost shooting 50% as a team from deep. And that's why Miami, they weren't really that great shooting threes, because they, you know, their style, they was kind of getting washed up and all that stuff. So San Antonio just blew them out shooting threes. So I think it was kind of proven right there before Steph. But Steph, and you know, his look and stuff, and him being the pioneer of shooting threes and making it so iconic, he really revolutionized it. But anyway, the point of me making this video, the hype around NBA's rookie Trae Young, is that he may be the NBA's next Stephen Curry. He's light-skinned, he can shoot, he pulls up from deep with almost like limitless range. There are not too many bad shots for players like that, or at least Stephen Curry and Trae Young, and that's pretty much been his trademark and why he was drafted so high, even traded up for. Never forget that. That can be, you know, one of the biggest mistakes in NBA history of Luka Doncic continuing the path that he's going right now, that, you know, at only age 19, because remember, the Hawks traded Luka Doncic to, you know, the Mavericks for Trae Young. So that was a pretty big, bold move. And if it doesn't work out, like I said, that can be one of the biggest mistakes in NBA history, depending on how Luka Doncic looks. But to get back on topic, the comparison of Trae Young and Stephen Curry is completely unfair to Trae Young and ultimately disrespectful to Stephen Curry, the legend. Trae Young is shooting 28% from deep. Not trying to be funny and, you know, not trying to disrespect Trae Young, but you know whose rookie season that's closer to? Russell Westbrook's rookie season. Actually, if you take a deep dive into Russell and Trae's rookie season numbers, they're quite similar in a lot of ways. I mean, scarily similar. 15 points per game, you know, about 39% from the field, about 28% from deep, you know, almost like the same exact thing. So it's looking like shooting wise, he might be closer to Russell Westbrook, as, you know, at least at this stage of his career, and at Russell Westbrook's early stages of his career, rather than Stephen Curry, the greatest shooter ever. Remember, Stephen Curry has never shot under 40% from deep in his entire career, not as a rookie, not right now. He's never shot under 40%, not from the field, but I'm talking about from deep. That is one of the most that's just incredible, man. That's just unbelievable for a player to be that accurate at the hardest spot to shoot at on the court. He's never even shot under 45% from the field in his career as a 6'3 point guard. So you see my point of this video is saying Stephen Curry isn't Stephen Curry just because he can hit a few shots from deep. He's who he is because of how accurate he is from an area on the court that is the hardest spot to hit from. And he's making it look like almost a layup every single time he's out on the court. I mean, Stephen Curry is almost in his 10th season right now. So he's not just having a 1, 2, 3 year, you know, career where he's averaging 40% from deep. He's doing it every single year. And right now, Stephen Curry is averaging almost 29 points per game, and it's so, you know, it's not really documented because he's so under the radar, because it's almost like you expect it now because he's Stephen Curry. Also, you know, as great as Steph is, you have to account that he has the perfect team that is built around to complement his style, because that's basically what Steve Kerr put around him. He has the second best shooter, Klay Thompson, Kevin Durant, one of the best shooters in the world, now DeMarcus Cousins and Draymond Green, you know, the muscle man. So he just has the perfect team, and Trae Young, he might not ever get that chance. He might not ever get that team. So the comparison is just not fair. Trae Young, I'm not saying he can't have a successful career or he can't be great in his own way, but remember, there's only one Steph Curry, and there's only ever going to be one Steph Curry, because he's unique because of his accuracy, and he's able to do it every single year. And the way he changed the game is unbelievable, the impact. It might be the greatest impact on a game ever. So, you know, that's that. And Trae Young, you would never follow in those footsteps, and that's not a bad thing. He has his own legacy. Steph has his own legacy, and that's pretty much that. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Leave a comment about what you guys think about the comparison. Follow my social medias. And until next time, stay tuned. Stay tuned, Jay.